The FIVB World League finals have come to the home of the Olympic champions, Brazil, as this year's top six teams battle it out for gold. Up next is the champions of 2014 USA against the 2015 champions France, right here in Curitiba. Welcome, Clayton Lucas here with you for our second game from day one of the FIVB World League Finals. And up next, it's a battle royale between the USA and France, two teams who have history here at this competition. Two teams with success under their belts, albeit a while ago. And a few new faces as well, as you get to see Everill of the USA. Familiar face in John Spiror, also Tori DeFalco. A few familiar faces for France in the form of the captain Benjamin Tonayuti, Stephane Boyer playing in the opposite slot today, and another familiar face in the captain Laurent Tilly, the coach. Certainly captaining the team from the sidelines. The warm-up just about coming to an end. One match already played, and that was between Brazil and Canada. If you haven't seen that one, then you should go and have a look, obviously, after this game has finished. Olympics having just finished, we have a look at the team for France, and there are a few players who we recognize: Grebennikov, the libero, Tonayuti setting, Engapet for the outside, the enigmatic Engapet, who really is a superstar. It's not Le Golf, by the way, it's Le Golf. It's a slight error with the graphics, I'm sure they'll fix that. I'm sure he likes a game of golf. And for the USA, a few players we've not seen before: Jendrik McDonald, Patch, Benjamin Patch, who is an opposite player who's taken over for the moment for Mr. Anderson, Matt Anderson. Also DeFalco, Averill. It's an exciting time for USA volleyball as they rebuild and look to the next Olympic Games as this new cycle starts for most of the teams as they start to blood players, and the more experienced players and the old guard start to move out of the team. So it's now time for us to have the national anthems from both countries.
Execução do hino nacional da França.
comes over. Time to meet the referees in charge today. From Brazil, the first official is Paulo Turci. Picture, and he will be ably assisted by Italy's Fabrizio Pasquale. Lazio supports here, or sporting a fashionable beard. The referees, the best of luck. We'll know if they've had a good game, because as always, we won't notice them. All our attention will be on the players and the volleyball. And it's time now to meet the players. The starting lineup for the USA has Yeshki at number one, position one. The outside hitting at position two will be number four. Jendrik, the middle blocker, at three. As John Spall gets his acknowledgement, is Christensen, Mika Christensen setting. Through the outside, starting at four, is Taylor Sander. Number 20, David Smith, the other middle blocker through, starting at five, and the opposite player today for the USA is number 14, Benjamin Patch. This is the French lineup. Tony Uti at six, number six is setting, starting position one. Bottom right, Laurent Tilly, the head coach, putting out his best six as he sees it. Engapest starts at two. Top right, number nine, outside hitting LaRue. And James going through the middle. Piniel through the outside, number eight. And Boyer, number 12, in the opposite slot. LaRue is 10. Genesi is 21. French team making their way out onto court. No Puyol in the team for France. Second setter for this tournament is Antoine Brizard, number 11. Krebenikov, the libero. Excellent player is Krebenikov. As Brizard gets his introduction, and now in comes Chinanizi. Just like the USA, a few familiar faces and a few new faces. So players ready, the crowd here are ready in Kirishima. We are moments away from getting this match going. Second ref just checking the lineups, making sure they're right so that the libero can come in. Eric Sochi libero for the USA. His brother Kawika Sochi, the captain, not on court for the moment. It's France in blue serving the USA in red receiving. This is match two from day one of the FIVB World League Finals here in Brazil, Curitiba. And it's the USA who have side out. Quick ball out wide. Sander ripping it off the block. And that sends Jendrik back to the serving line. Got slowed down by Smith. Smith has moved up into starting middle block position. He's a substitute during the course of the Olympic Games. He's got his opportunities as France have their side out, their opening point. Now Smith very much first six for the USA. Krupenikov making the dig. Patch getting involved. Beth getting a point. That one just landing in court. Is it great to see all these new players coming in to the teams? Canada have a new opposite in the form of Vernon. He touches 374 patch for the USA, who's round about the same height as well in terms of how, where he hits the ball. Touches 368, so not much between them. Nice pass from Shoji. All about the pass, getting the platform right, and then Patch coming in, getting block out. Unfortunately for Engapeth, he was on the 3 metre line as he took off. He's a backcourt player. He has to take off from behind that white line in order to play the ball. Just as he's towed it with his left foot. Good spot from the camera. There's Doug. High and wide for Sander. Turns it into the block for the recycle. Has to do it again. This time brings the heat, but it's dealt with by Grebennikov. In a turn of fortunes, it's Liniel who gets block out off of Patch. Interesting duel developing between those two players. Good dig from Grebennikov, just soaking up the pressure. Excellent swing from Liniel. A lot of copycat play from these two teams as they both like to run the pipe attack. Engapet doing the business for France. We'll see Sander doing the same thing for the USA. Smith. That was unlucky, Smith going after it, but getting his timing slightly wrong. He and the ball meeting the floor at the same time. Good swing from Boyer. Gets out of the way of the ball. Neil brings the heat. That sends Patch back to the serving line. Christensen into the front row. Along with Jeschke. And blocking has just worked wonders. Nice play from Jindrik. With Jeschke, it's Jeschke who gets the block. Patch will serve again. USA now opening up a 2-point margin. Nice pass from Engapet, gets it back. Classic swing hitting from him, and he goes block out. So often now we're seeing these world-class outside hitters working from around about the 3 metre line, as they're having to be brought off the net somewhat because of the level of serving. But still no problem at all in dealing with it. Sander is a real jack in the box. He gets so high, that ball was almost too low for him. And he's trying to hit it too steep. The Goff getting an eyeful. hustle from France. Nice dig from Patch. He might get this one back. He will. And he gets an excellent block out. We head into the first technical. It's the USA with a slim lead. First opportunity to run the middle. Legoff putting the ball away for France. USA comes straight back with their side out. Jeschke working the pipe. Still a little bit of movement for Toniuti as he tried to keep that one off the floor. Too much on that, although USA asking for a touch off the block, they've got it. They're all going to the coach, call a challenge. Right, looking at the first ref who's signaled the touch. It's Leroux who made the touch. Hitting in the same rhythm in which he went to attack the ball, and Sander was all over that. Head-to-head stats between these two teams. They've met 17 times. USA have won 9, France have won 8. And in the latest encounter, it was the USA who took the victory 3-1. Had to change that. It was France who won 3-1. The USA who won at the Olympic Games 3-1 in Rio last year. Almost as if it's supposed to go behind, but they're getting a big paw on the ball. USA get it recycled though, and Patch. Well, they're going to have to patch up the hole in the floor he's just made, aren't they? That was an incredible swing. Spiror loving it, the fans loving it. Boom, indeed a boom. As he goes over Liniel.
Yeah,
USA making decent inroads into this set. First set, leading by four. Christensen back to the serving line. So Pat's now into the front row. Big lineup for the USA. Excellent play. It's not that easy for the lefties to hit on the left side of court. Lineal having to ply his trade on that side as a swing hitter. LaRue now goes back to serve. Sander this time with the jump, the hang and then the swing, changing his rhythm. He liked it. Finished. Just watch Patch's block. He's up. Well, in fact, he goes early, doesn't he? There's no block. A free swing for Lineal. Quality stuff from France. Lovely swing from Smith as he cuts that away onto the corner of the 3 meter line and the sideline. As that's overpassed, and we hit the second technical timeout. USA with a healthy lead in this first set.
Toujours un peu en retard. Bonne réception, vous sentez en fixe. Et dès qu'il court, on fait l'inverse. Quelques balles.
USA's record coming into these finals was 5-4. At one point they were looking like they weren't going to make it, but had a rally in their last few matches to get the wins they needed to send them through to these finals. And now they're here, they're doing okay. Rontilli and his team have some work to do. Nice serve from Smith. Excellent pass by Grebennikov, which allows the middle to run. And a little bit of hesitation between Smith and Sander in the after you, no, after you. And in the end, neither of them getting it. Had to be Sander's ball. Smith couldn't go anywhere. Jeski turning that one back to the line, going over Tonyuti. A big mismatch that the USA will keep exploiting here for as long as they can. A chance for France to bring that back. Miss hit from Patch. Patch still at university. He's at Brigham Young University in the USA. Jeffrey Yendrick is at Loyola, University of Chicago. And another player still at uni, at Long State Uni, is Torre DeFalco. The outside hitter currently on the bench. Such is the youth that Sperro has brought in. So that goes off of Jeski and out of play. Thank you. Taylor Sanders plying his trade in Qatar at the moment for El Arabi Sports Club. And Ishki, who was just wiped, is playing in Poland for Seco Rozovia. France waiting for the pipe, but unfortunately unable to deal with it. Plenty of heat in the serve, but only the net feeling it. Sport doesn't often show his emotions, he's pretty calm, which is a good thing. It's not about the coach, it's about the players. And that's the one thing all good coaches learn pretty quickly. It's not about them. USA have their side out. Very quick up and down for Njendrik. Timing issues for France. And a 5-point lead developed by the USA. Just a little bit too high for Gliniel. Been caught out by the net. A little bit too much to do at the moment. France led off the hook. Engepet goes back to serve now for Le Bleu. Oh, that's a top serve. Ball straight back over. And it's Engepet who tries to put it away, but Sander denies him. Say not really having to adjust to the backcourt attack. Sander was waiting. Engepeth not happy with that. Mika Christensen. Excellent ball in from Grupenikov. And Patch almost made the dig. Lovely swing from Boyer. Penikov having to make a really good adjustment as that ball clipped the net. And then Stéphane Boyer, who plays in France for Chaumont, making sure that ball didn't come back. LaRue, big serve from him. No middle attack coming now for the US. Sander tries with the tip, but he's rejected. That wasn't high enough. And easy throws it down. France call the timeout. missing your serve's never a good thing, especially not at the business end of a set, giving the opposition a free point. And now they're only 3 points away from taking the set. As Sander delivers, well, he doesn't, does he? He doesn't deliver. So the favour returned. There's going to be a substitution. Boyer's going off. And Antoine Brizard coming in. Double substitution, and that also brings in Thibaut Rossard as opposite. So some height at the net for France as they try and get back into this set. Grabenikov keeps it in play. Lunel with some work to do. Better chance now as Grabenikov pops it in. And Lunel gets it off the block and away. The double substitution pays instant dividends as France take a point from the serving line. Getting the ball into transition. Spiror not showing any emotion. At least he's trying not to. Rizal once again. Excellent ball in. Joust at the net, and it's off of France in a way. Chieschi gets the point. Referee with a firm point to Rossard, saying it came off him last. Oh, so tricky, isn't it? USA really struggling from the serving line at the moment. Fortunately for them, they build up a five-point lead and did a little bit of emotion that time from Spiror. Christensen trying to fire that ball all the way out over the other side of the court, despite his body weight going away from where he was trying to set to. It was a little bit low and inside. Compounded by Jeski, and now France back to within one as Lunel fires another rocket, but it's well passed, and Patch destroys the ball down the line, and it's set point now for the USA. What a good ball in that was from Shoji, and that is a monster swing, a super spike from Patch. Grabenikov too quick for him. Set point for the USA, and it's Koika Shoji, the captain, who's come on to court to serve. Decent serve as well, no middle attack for Franz Engepet to keep them in. The rally they have done, they stay in the set. So make sure the rally ends with France taking the point. And it's now one clear opportunity for the USA to win the set from side out. There's a top swing from Engepet. Another chance for the USA. Sander, oh, it's a hitting error from Sander as he takes off on the 3 meter line. And set point is saved by France. Oh, he's miles over. The hard work by France to keep the ball off the floor, giving it back to the USA, paid dividends. And easy with the serve again. Still set point opportunities now, but they can't take it from service Eve. And Engapeth could bring a set point up chance here for France. Scramble on both sides. Nice dig from Shoji. And Patch is blocked. Engapeth and Leroux combine, and it's turned around, and France have set point. Great reactions on both sides of the net. Lovely recovery from Patch, but what a block as Leroux becomes outside blocker, Engapeth middle blocker, and the combination works brilliantly. There'll be some of you watching who only have ever known rally point scoring. But there used to be a time, way back in black and white, when the volleyball was white, when you could only score a point from service. And the one thing that rally point does is it brings us back to that. When we get to 24, we go back to old school, where you have to win from service. And that's exactly what both these teams have to do now. It's France in the box seat. And that might stay in play. It will stay in play. Engapeth might try something, and he did, and fair play to him. He had license to do it. If that had come off, it would have been the set for France. Really tricky. He's got his back to the net, turning to try and hit after he made the dig initially. Almost. But now it's France siding out to get a set point chance again. Oh, good dig from Liniel. And again, France hustling. And it's block out from Engapeth. Well, he's an enigma, is Engapeth. You just can't take your eyes off him. This is quality. He's gone for the hands of Sander. And it's worked. Set point number two for France. Big serve. And it's an error from France as they miss. An error from the USA as France take the set. And what a turnaround. Le Bleu stealing that one right from under the USA's noses. Just set too high for Jendrik. Getting their timing wrong. First set that was. USA had a set point chance, couldn't side it out to take it, and it's France who pinch it from them, 27-25. Thank you. USA get the second set underway after blowing a five-point lead and missing a stack of serves in that first set. So allow France back in. And that's just clipped the block as it goes out, although players not agreeing. So there's going to be a challenge. Referee thought he saw it off the block. Unforced error it is from France, and that sends Jeschke back to serve again. France's serve receive unit quite a way back. Happy to see that one go wide. LaRue, but he'll take it. It did look as if he threw that ball too far into court. He was playing catch up. Looked as if the net was going to get in the way totally. But in the end, the stats will say a serve. It doesn't matter how you get them. Too tight to the net. Patch makes up for it for the USA as they get their opportunity once again. In the context of things, you can understand jump serves being missed. They're high risk, you're hitting the ball hard from way back, but to miss a jump float serve, sure, sometimes difficult to get to grips with. Sander, brilliant, this time hitting that one almost on the way up. In fact, he was, wasn't he? It's lovely to see those kind of hits where not quite reach the top of your jump, have the swing, and then have a little lurk, and then come down. Nice ball in from Grebennikov. And Boyer makes sure that that ball hits the floor. Sander leaving too much line. It's too late in the block. Excellent pass from Shoji. Looks like watching a mirror image. These two teams, similar builds, almost identical styles of play. Thank you. there is one big difference between them at the moment. It's serving errors, and the USA making more than France. It was unlucky. Engepet playing that into the block to try and have it recycled. Didn't quite work out as they would have liked. LaRue late to react. Engepet denied. Lovely work from the USA. That was all very tight at the net. But it was Patch working his magic. Smith. It looked very nice from Gripennikov as he jumped to make the set to Engepet, but it was all too telegraphed. Tonyuti not quite having the strength to force the ball down over Jayski. And then Patch just putting the roof on Engepet. Again, Tonyuti out hustled. Don't often see that by setters. Only they win the jousts. And Patch wins the point. First technical of the second set. USA lead by three. Smith once more for the US. Engepet changes the rhythm this time. Just waits a little bit so he can work the block. Tomiuti with the serve. Jayski struggling, but keeps the ball in play. Uniel dispatches that from the pipe. Covered by Hendrik. Brilliant put away from Liniel. That's more like it from the US this time. Christensen and Hendrik combining well in the middle. covering by Christensen. Jeski with some work to do. Oh, brilliant from Toniuti. Both teams having to scramble. Jeski wanted to make sure it was a rally-ending play with that swing. It certainly was, but not in favour of the USA. Great play from Toniuti. And it works well for Team Yavbo in the end. Oh, well done by Sander, playing that ball, missing the drink station. But it's France who take the point through Boyer. What a chase this is from Sander. Did so well to get the ball back and not hurt himself. But Patch couldn't stop Boyer. Chase that one a little bit. A few players have done that now, thrown the ball a little bit too far in front of them. And he's having to stretch at the point of impact with their hand, not getting the contact they'd like. Jeski has a habit of letting his left side, his left arm, drift away from him, which technically can cause him a few issues, but when you're 198, it kind of overrides that somewhat. Excellent. That one catching LaRue in the unmentionables. He gets to go off and have a little think about it. Drobenikov's come in now for service eve duties. Jendrick with the serve for US. France responding kind, going to the middle themselves, keeping the lead. Oh, excellent. Smith has got the ability to hit left and right. He is a class player in the middle. He's not one-dimensional. Finding the gaps, putting the ball away. Just like the first set, this one is one that you feel could go either way, despite the fact the USA had a five-point lead in set one, and it did look, to all intents and purposes, as they were cruising. France turned it right around from 23-24 down to take it 27-25. Liniel. So Domenikov making the dig, all to no avail. This is a net touch by France. Those pesky middle blockers smashing the outside hitters and setters into the net. See that quite a bit. Yeah, doing the business for France once again. Smith actually drifting past the point of impact. Rally. Oh, it's a. Well, it was going to be France's point, but it's not now. An illegal attack given against Engapet. to sideline. Christensen giving up too much down that line. Happy though to run the middle whenever he can. LaRue having to guess which way the ball is going to go. Patch with the serve. Just 23 years of age, such a bright future he's got. Whilst Matt Anderson isn't involved at the moment, having had a heavy season in Russia with Kazan, Benjamin Patch is making a name for himself for the USA. Fantastic setting we have here in Grinchy, but this stadium, normally used for football, the ceiling, the roof is on, it begins for volleyball. Plenty of fans in to watch. Patch with the serve. Excellent commit block by the USA, denying France, but not at the second time as Engapet gets the ball down. Little look through the net as well afterwards. Very nonchalant, Engapet. Blocked, but do you know what? Somebody needs to be a bit deeper. Everybody kind of rushing in. I think most of the team were inside the 3 meter line covering, and nobody deep to deal with what was a pretty tame shot into the block. To be recycled as it is, USA have the point at a 2 point lead now as well. Not taking that for granted though, after what happened in the first set. Nice set. Good up from Tony Uti. Engapet once again makes the setting look easy. And it's the USA now have wrestled back an opportunity. Oh, no one quite in sync with Christensen on that play, and it could be France who take advantage, but it's an unforced error, is it? No. It's been given as in. Well, the entire US team thought it was out. The line judge said out. Straight past Sander. Boyer knew it was in. He's got through that, hasn't he, Boyer? It'll be LaRue to serve. Well, that's a shame, because Sander missed that one. Unforced error by France going into the net. Again, middle blockers. There's a couple of schools of thought as we see Sander celebrate his error. Schools of thought on middle blockers going out wide. Just get out there, hell for leather, take off laterally and try and get your hands in position, which is great as USA make an excellent block. But the risks to that are, as we have witnessed in this match, that you're smashing into your outside blocker, which can knock them into the net, or alternatively, you can land on their foot, or they can land on yours. Or the other school of thought is get out there quickly, post your foot back towards the net, your outside foot, and get up and across the net. New player onto court for France, Trevor Clevenot, number five. And Smith makes sure that ball doesn't come back. But if you don't get an ace, the next best thing is this, an overpass, which is put away. Satisfying for Smith, satisfying for the team, who now lead by four. Well, a better ball in by Angerpet than no trouble for Chinanisi to put it away. Nice up from Grigbenikov. Oh, what a set that is. But what a block from France. Patch trying to hit a winner. They were out of system, the USA. Wasn't the best opportunity for Patch. And he is put down. Cheshki makes sure that time. Can the USA get themselves the 3 points they need to level things up? Or do France have something up their sleeves to turn it around like they did in set one? Christensen will serve. Big front row now for the USA as Patch moves into it with Smith and Sander. And they're putting some pressure on Angerpet. That's a double touch though. Even though Antoine Brizard is the setter, he's not being allowed to get away with that one.
Flottant, tu sers sur la diagonale. Tu sers en face, réception.
USA 2 points away from levelling the match. Oh dear, that one just got away from Christensen. He'll put that out of his mind as he gets ready to orchestrate the USA's side out. Three front court hitting options to choose from, plus Jeski on the pipe attack. And all options available. Somehow kept off the floor. But that's into the antenna from Engerhead, and it's set point now for the USA. To see how late Sanders' block is. His now moment was way after Enkepet had the swing. But it's Sander who'll serve for the set. Little jump floater. USA have it back in transition. Jeski. Good dig from Enkepet. Another chance here though for the US. And it's Sander who does the business. USA take the set 25-20 and level the match at one set all. Top swing from Sander. A fair number of fans have stayed on after the first game where Brazil played Canada to watch this one. And they are being entertained not only by the court announcer but also by USA and France, who are having a real go at each other. Some venue. France going back to the starting six from the first set. And the same for the USA. As the third set gets underway, France with the serve, Taniuti with it. Nice from Grebennikov. Is that off the fingers? No, it's not. They're going to challenge. Engerpet screaming at Tilly to call the challenge. They saw, are sure it was off of USA's block, and LaRue saying he heard it. really not going to be good enough. It needs to have seen it. So are they just guessing? Or did it really hit USA's block? One thing's for sure, we are going to find out.
Number four.
The official review, which is a freeze frame on the big screen at the moment, says touch. So, good call and fantastic hearing skills from LaRue. Although Engelbert saw it. 1-0 for France. And now, yes, they have their side out. Patch held his ground pretty well. Unfortunately, he was still moving a little bit backwards, couldn't take the full energy of the ball. See, on his heels. You say going after Engelbert pretty much all the time from serve. Not liking his passing, I feel they can get more from that. That's an unforced error from France Boyer. With the mistake. This match certainly has the potential to go to five sets, but as to who will win it, with the way the two teams are playing, is anybody's guess. Christensen. Engelbert looking for touch, but it's been given. Referee initially set out and then changed his mind, but no complaints coming from the US. Referee just making sure everyone calms down. Patch getting a big part of the ball. Excellent serve from LaRue. Recovering from Liniel deep at six. Bit of a throw from Engelbert, got away with that. Another chance here for France. Engelbert having to get out wide. Cover by LaRue. Well done from him. Deep. And that's a better ball into the middle. Hammered away by Chinonisi. Well, that's definitely a throw from Engelbert. 80s style volleyball. Definitely not 80 style volleyball. Another big serve from LaRue. Good up by Tony Uti. There's the USA scrambling. Boyer back on track. France with a 3-point lead. Spiror trying to get his team going. But it's France who are going well at the moment. Serving pressure that time. It's USA who get the side out. Well watched by Christensen. Match looking for a touch this time. Not being given. No challenge coming. It's good up from Christensen. Danielle did well to let that one go. Smith for the US. Kept in play by Boyer. Oh, that was very nice, but well watched by Patch. But no one stopping the middle. Ginnanese once again. He's having a bit of a field day against Jendrik. Makes up for it with a decent swing himself. Well, Patch pretty much threw that one over the net. So the technical timeout, France lead by three in this very evenly balanced game. Having to throw everything at it, but LaRue getting himself into the net. Oh dear. A bit of perspiration on that one. Jeschke once again. Work by Linnell and by Blair. Oh, great cover from Christensen. And as a result of that, it's the USA who take the point. Daniel. Work by USA's block, once again slowing that ball down. But it's Sander, just hit the ball so steep, getting blocked out. It's interesting, you watch Sander on the pipe and he travels through the ball and he hits great, but it's these occasions when he gets up close to it, he's got a vertical jump, doesn't travel into the ball so much, just seems to lack a few ranges of shots to go off the block and away at times. Rue doesn't mind though. Tonyuti getting turned. No chance for Boyer. Good work that time from Boyer. So he gets a touch off the block in a way. Catching a part of Jeschke. More like it from Engapet. That is a world-class pass from Shoji. Oh, what a take from Grigmenikov! And it's an error against the USA. Well, unfortunately for Sander, he couldn't stay from going under the net, all thanks to Grebennikov throwing his face in the line. His athleticism from Christensen and then from Patch. Patch, who I mentioned, plays his volleyball at college. Well, he won't be going there for much longer at Brigham Young University. He'll be off to Italy later on in the year. Still, though, a few rookie errors from him. Understandable from the youngster. But he does have a bright future. Will take him to Europe to play his volleyball in one of the top leagues in the world. Nice play. The outside hitters combining as Engapet goes to Liniel. And at the technical timeout, France with a comfortable lead.
Aggressive. We're getting them a little bit of media pass. We're getting some opportunities here, okay? Just keep keep passing the ball inside now. Keep passing it inside. Good.
Straightforward side out for the USA. There's a top swing as well, going over the block from Jeschke and finding the sideline. Straightforward at this level. Jeschke snatching. Fluid rhythm he normally has, but also his contact point was a little bit low. Nothing wrong with that swing, however, from Thomas Jeschke. Both teams siding out comfortably at the moment. Trying to go to the middle. Good dig. Off ball situation. Oh well. Boyer's tried to hit a winner. I don't think his coach will be overly pleased with that. Nice play from Patch. That's a great pickup from Engepet. But with France out of system, Boyer just needed to keep that in play, didn't he? Easier said than done. Jendrik. Well, he struggled a little bit with his jump float serve. USA's block holding firm, and that gives them a valuable point as they creep closer to France. Shutting down Engepet. It's great to watch that pipe. Which begs the question for how much longer will we get to watch it? There are plans afoot and rule changes being tested, which would take the pipe out of the game. Nice from Gripennikov, unfortunately for him, it's outside the antenna. FIVB have trialled two rule changes recently at the junior competition as we have a timeout. That is taking off from behind the serve line and staying behind it to serve jumps, and similarly from the pipe attack, the backcourt attack, taking off and staying behind the 3 metre line.
On attend, on ne fait en attente. Ok. Le ciel vous parle sur la réception. Allez, on a
France still in the driving seat in this set. USA trying to wrestle control. Smith, once again, he's been resolute in offense. When he's been given the ball, he's done amazing things with it. Just hasn't seen enough of it from USA's point of view. Also been pretty good from the serving line. France responding kind. Taniuti going straight to the middle for Chinanisi to put the ball away. Massive commit block. Chinanisi shutting out Taylor Sander. Monster block from France. Bit of a shock for Sander. That one too far in front, had to check his spike, his serve, which is pretty much a spike at this level, and that allows the USA to get a comfortable side out. Substitution from the US as in comes Shoji with the serve. Well, a single substitution, I should say, he's come on for a patch, but now he'll go off again. Not opting to take Christensen out of the front row and bring another opposite in. As France have their side out. Who has been pretty much unstoppable at collegiate level, certainly is finding out all about international volleyball at the highest level. And it's set point now for Le Bleu. Not before a timeout is called, though. put away again. Middle working well for the US. Once they get it going. Nice dig, Engapet. Great reactions from Danielle. Engapet again. Oh dear, but confusion, Grebennikov and Liniel. Grebennikov saying, come on, that's my ball, you need to get ready for a hit. This may well be that Liniel had his eyes on the volleyball only. He didn't see that Grebennikov was going to play it as well. And it's the USA who take the point. Set point then for France, and the opportunity to get it done from side out. Jeschke will serve for the US. Is he going to go for it? Well, he certainly is. That's a decent pass from Liniel. Shoji makes the dig. And Sander gets the block out. First set point saved. Another error. LaRue misses the block, and the USA have leveled up. Well, that's a big miss from LaRue. This is a good serving run from Jeschke. He's done his job. He's brought the US back into this. It's France who eventually get their side out and have set point again, but they're going to have to win it from the serving line. Tomiuti with the serve. And it's a massive block from France. Sander put down. Lillard of Afters through the net, but they don't care, France, because they now lead 2-1. Once again, Sander just hits so steep all the time, doesn't he? And Boyer had him in his pocket. Oh, big roar through the net from Boyer. That's a bit naughty. Sander didn't like that much. Tomiuti loved it. Thank you. Here's a view of where the sets have gone, distribution-wise, and where the ball has been hit from. Average spike, 3.19 metres. The net is 2.43 metres, which is about 8 foot, the same height as the crossbar in football. So you get a good idea of just how high these guys are getting and how, and where they're hitting the ball. Can't miss that one. A little bit of volleyball your way going on. Players back out onto court, ready for set number four. Could be the last set. And France have their way, but it's the USA with the serve. A must-win set for the US. We're overturning. Try to force that one off the block and away, but not catching anybody. That's a lovely play from France. Very quick combination. Engapeth over the top of Leroux. Engapeth with a little bit of afters through the net. Oh, brilliant. Liniel with the ace serve. That's a top serve, but it's the first time he's hit one of those in the match. Jeschke just stepped inside, couldn't react, get back to his right. France take the point, four touches signalled. Effort that from Patch, but all to no avail. Leroux with the serve. Just for a second. It goes down in front of Smith on the USA side. Nice read from Smith, might get a chance in the middle, and he does. Grebennikov's onto it. Boyer hoiks it back into play. Oh, that would have been spectacular had Engapeth managed to find the line. As it is, USA take the point and level things up. So unlucky for Engepep. This time the ball goes down. Smith is unable to stop, but Chiminizi. Engepeth's serving style drops his left side quite a bit, leans to the left as he rotates through the ball. Didn't get enough topspin on that last one to bring it in play. It'll be Smith for the US. Very different style of jump serve from him. Stays a lot straighter, pikes as he hits the ball. Piking forward. Nice defense from the US. And it's an unforced error from France. Time Boyer makes sure it stays in play. Too hot for the US to handle. Chance for France to take the lead at the technical timeout. Well, it's not going to happen. Liniel forces it wide, and it's the US who lead at the first technical timeout, but it's France who lead by 2-1 in the match.
On est bien, comme ça. On a limité deux, trois fautes et après on est là, ok? On joue simple, efficace. Fin, simple et efficace. Je te répète, on est toujours en attente au bloc, ok? On est toujours en attente. À la fin, on sera gagnant, d'accord? Ok? Allez, gars,
opting for the jump float serve. Generates the overpass though. And this time, Jendrik puts it on the floor. Too easy for Liniel, who was able to volley that ball in. Liniel's got that look about him, doesn't he? Like he's just got out of bed. Nothing sleepy about that performance. Christensen. Frustrating France, and no doubt frustrating Toniutu as well, because Toniutu's at one, so he can't reply in kind by going over on two himself with the next opportunity. LaRue, though, out to lunch with that one. Some real quality from the US, from pass to set to spike. Dustin Watton, the second libero for the US, waiting for his opportunity to get on. What a block from Christensen. As the USA start to take charge of this set. Monster block from Christensen. One-on-one, taking away the cross, leaving Engepet down. And so much so, Engepet has now been substituted. Into the action comes Trevor Klevno. Not quite going to get over. And France take the point. Excellent play from Smith. Good D from Sander. And how about that? Little reverse dig to the middle from Christensen. USA are definitely on a roll now. Showed you with a super dig. Sander finishing it off. And the States leading by five. France call timeout. Another look at that swing again from Smith. And the dig. That time though, France get the block out. Heavy serve from France, but it matters not as Patch gets the point for the US.
First one he threw.
players ready and waiting, want to get back onto court. Want to stay warm. The USA with a hefty lead, it's looking like. We're going to go to a deciding fifth set. Unless France can find a way back into this one. So far, so good for the United States in this set. Sander with the serve. Side out achieved by France. Patch leaving too much line. It's a good rescue from Christensen, but a net touch by Smith as he hit jousts at the net. Good leave from Shoji. Best of swings from Rosard. And it just kind of keeps the momentum with the USA. He's way up there. The ball goes way out. Over the top, making full use of his 3.68 meters leap. No stopping that one. On the serves and the errors, 19 serving errors. It's almost a set's worth of points given away by the USA on serve so far in this match. Patch tries to work the block, but it's France who have a chance, and Liniel takes it. Still not entirely comfortable for the US. Christensen with a nice one off the chest. But it's France who take the point eventually. Giannese putting the US in trouble. Ball volleyed way too close to the net. And 2 points in a row for France. Giving something for the USA to think about potentially. Spiro not looking to call a timeout just yet. Giannese will serve again. Better ball in this time, but not a best of contacts from Jendrik. And Liniel has wrapped it off the block and away, and now maybe the alarm bell's beginning to ring for the US. Or maybe not. They're all letting it ride. So Jeschke gets the block out. Panic over, maybe. Shoji. Shoji comes in as Patch goes off. With the error through two, but they're going to challenge this one. Did that come off of Thomas Jeschke as it went wide? No, it didn't. So it will be a point for the USA.
Net touch.
Oh, are they asking for a net touch?
Okay. Net.
Didn't touch the block as it went out.
No fault.
Did the block touch the net?
Okay, go.
Not overly sure what's been asked for. All we've got is the challenge graphic. So here's the review. Well, there's no net touch. The net was going up and down from a previous part of the rally where the ball caught it. So no fault of the net and no touch in the block. And the USA do indeed have the point. 21-16, edging closer to levelling the scores and sending this into a deciding fifth set. Shoji once again, deep breath as he sets himself for the jump serve. Oh dear. Well, that's an unforced error from France. They had the heart of the USA's defence to go at. Roussard was unable to find it. Soji once again with the serve, flirting with the net, and this time flirting with it too much. Caught it on the last two serves. This time they wouldn't let him get the ball over. Patch comes back in. He's got some hitting to do on the right side in the back row. No, he won't have to. Roussard with the error, and the double substitution is going to be reversed now. Boyer comes back in, Toniuti comes back in. Jeschke with the serve. 2 points required for the US. Excellent pass from Grebennikov. But it's another error. Goodness me, what is happening to France? But it's set point for the USA. France are in trouble, it's not coming back. It's an ace serve from Jeschke. USA take the set 25-17. We're heading into a decider. Jeschke doing to Liniel what he did to the US early in the last set. That means now we're gonna head into this final set, the race to 15. There's no technical timeouts. So have a look at the highlights from the match so far.
Thank you.
France are keeping Trevor Klevno on court for this deciding set. No place for Irvin Engapet. That's the only change. As we get ready for this race to 15. Toniuti with the serve for France. Good dig from Grebennikov. And again, better chance now for France maybe. Boyer looked like he was going to be stopped. Well, he was. However, the ball goes out of court and France take the point. And that is an excellent start for them, taking the first point, especially as they were serving. Toniuti once more. Hatch gets the block out. Got some of the block? No, he hasn't. Some of the errors that were in evidence towards the end of the last set are creeping in here at the start of the decider. France incredibly have challenged block touch. And we've already had a view. Well, they've challenged in out. Sure why they did that, because they've just lost a challenge. We were all wondering whether or not it caught the block because it was so far out. So after that very bright start for France, taking the first point from serve, they now find themselves down. They could be down by a couple here. As that one's been thrown wide. And is there going to be another challenge? No, there isn't. So, a big turnaround pretty quickly. 3-1, but Jendrik's serving woes come back to haunt him. And Liniel is struggling. Christensen. Oh, what a serve that is! What a serve from Christensen! Right into the traffic with Liniel, Boyer and Leroux, and they couldn't get out of the way. Christensen has come up with a brilliant serve, skittling France. Almost getting a strike, getting a point. Thank you. That's better. Boyer makes sure this time. LaRue missed his last serve. Well, he's done it again. Klivner makes sure. Patch late to finish the block. Klivner had already put the ball away. France can ill afford these serving errors. Laurent Tilly's trying not to show any emotion himself. But they're gifting USA points, not making them work for them. Smith readies himself to serve. Niel gets the side out. USA know if they can keep their side out game functioning, they could side their way out to an important victory here. All ifs and buts at the moment, though. Tonioti just flings it high. And Jendrik hammers it down. USA reach eight first as the teams will now change ends. Lovely sea quick, short behind, catching France by surprise. A little bit low, another chance maybe. Taken by Liniel. France did very well to recycle that. Chinenisi will serve. As Team Nyabba try and find a way back in for this set. A chance for a point here, a little bit tight to the net. Sander gets a hand on it. Jeski is put down. France back to within one. And it's still a set that is anybody's for the taking. And so too the match. Overpassed, Christensen's back row, he's played it on the side of France, and we're all square. Taking it away from LaRue. And now it's the USA's team turn to have a bit of a wobble. Easy put down for Liniel, and France have moved in front. And now USA call the timeout.
Yeah, where are they going to be next time?
we got to get our right hand on the middles over fast. He's gone through you guys a lot. So that lefty, just get over because he's seeing it, trying to get inside, but we got to stop that ball, okay?
All here, boys.
Yeah, that's right.
What's up? What's up?
What's up?
With the serve. USA want that side out. They're going to get it. We're to a situation now where teams, they can side out, can keep the advantage, which would be France, but only needs one slip up for that momentum to swing back the other way in favour of the US. Covering by Grubenikov, stay deep. Yeah! Liniel, just calm as you like, plays it off the block and out. There's still a lot of volleyball left in this match yet. Oh, that was unlucky, wasn't it? Jendrik catching it late. Another throw from Liniel, another point for France, and now they've engineered a two-point cushion. Nobody able to deal with that ball in the middle of court. What a time to get it. Benjamin Padge is put down. Oh, it's a huge block from LaRue. Well, this game has most definitely swung in France's favour, and Sander with the unforced error. But there's going to be a challenge. Did it catch the block? Sander's been very quiet in this last set, hasn't had a great deal to do, hasn't got the ball.
Yeah, okay, okay.
The USA need this to
number,
be number off
12,
the block and out.
Yes.
Difficult to gauge from LaRue's reaction whether he touched it or not. Well, I think he did. I think he did. Or did he? Is he nodding to say, yeah, I did touch it?
Successful challenge. Yes, okay.
No, he didn't. But it was Boyer who did. So a good challenge from the US. The score now 12-10, 10-12 rather. As USA have the ball. Guata coming on to serve. First time onto court for him. No pressure. Nice little serve. Yeah! Liniel puts the ball away. It's an instant side out for France. But they're two away from taking the match. Nice set from Tony Uti. And Liniel swings away down the line. The USA side out straight away. But it's all France now. They know if they side out, they're up to match point. And from there on in, the USA have their backs to the wall. Christensen back to serve. Big front row for the US. Sander Smith and Patch. Can they stop France? Sander gets a touch and he has a swing. Grubenikov keeps it in play. Oh, what a swing from Boyer! And that brings up match point. He unloaded on that one. Brought inside, the block's gone too wide. A free swing from Boyer. LaRue. Sander, has he just delayed the inevitable? Or is there still a twist in this tale? Sander, it will be to serve, but not before a timeout's been called by France. Sander's had some time to think about this serve. Oh, and he's put it too long and it's all over. France take the set 15-12 and the match by 3-2. What a victory for Les Bleus. And Team Yapo have come good just when they needed it. That's a big win for France, as they take a step closer to the semi-finals on day one of this competition of the World League Finals. Brilliant performance from them. What a close game that was. Could have gone either way. But in the end, it's France who have come out on top. Well, Sander went for it, but it's cost his team the match. Confirmation of the score in this epic five-set thriller. France taking the first set, saving set point in the pro. Coach Laurence Lee, what a game that was.
Yeah, incredible, because we were supposed to lose the first set, and at the The double change brought me a lot of energy, and we succeed to win this set, and I think this gives us a little bit more confidence. But it was very tough game because you never know who will win.
Especially when you get to the fifth set, what do you think was the deciding moment for you today?
The first set and the switches in the fourth set to prepare the tie break. And we, even if we were losing 3 points, we stay focused on the game, and that's very huge success for us.
Congratulations on the win, and we look forward to seeing how you get on in the next game.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, what a fantastic result that was for France. That just about wraps it up from all of us here. Time now to say goodbye, but before we go, we'll leave you with the highlights.